For you three gentlemen, I'm not sure who wants to field it, kind of talk about how your work has melded in with this story and how this opportunity came together.
We made together a film called I Can Only Imagine last year and just discovered the power of music and cinema. We just love bringing sort of a rush of hope to audiences, especially in the culture that we live in. You know, it's great to escape to a theater and just feel hope and feel optimism. And that certain sense of inspirational filmmaking is where we live, you know? And so we look for stories that move us first and foremost. Yeah. And when we heard Jeremy's story, sat down with an interview for a whole day with his wife, I just remember the way I felt and remember I couldn't stop thinking about the story. Couldn't stop thinking about how Melissa had said, if one person's life is changed by what I go through, it will have been worth it to tell my story. It just so deeply moved us that we're like, we have to make this movie. I think it'll be entertaining. I think you'll cry. But it's the tears you want to cry. It's tears of hope. Yeah. And it just is an incredible story, and we're honored to be able to tell it. And I think audiences are going to really love it.
For John and I, we can't direct or tell a story that we don't first have move our soul. And so the stories that we really fall in love with are the ones that really just impact us in such a way that we can't stop thinking about it. Our desire is to make things that are very relatable and very entertaining to the audience that we love.
I think there's an incredible underserved audience in Middle America, in the Heartland. And I think that we want to go to the movies with our families. You know, we want things that we can trust, and we want things that uplift and inspire and sort of push us towards who we want to become. And there's an incredible hunger for that. And I think that in the culture we live in today, that is amplified, that we just need hope now more than ever. And we need stories that inspire now more than ever. And I think that there's a cultural hunger for that. And so I think that when you tell these stories correctly, they're universally relatable and universally powerful. That's our goal anyway. And I still believe certainly is. I think it will move you for the better, no matter what you believe. Yeah. Well, it's gotta be-